certain richness to the being surrounded by all this shiny gold, you know what I'm saying? Same amount of crashes on both sides, the same amount of splashes. I like to have hi-hats on both sides, chinas on both sides. So if you actually look at the kit, it's set up in a way where it's almost a mirror image. I would suggest for any young drummer to go to their local music shop, and usually they'll have all the Sabian cymbals out for you to be able to bang on and hit and try out. And try to mix them up and match them up. Try to go with a lot of different sounds. To me, the biggest part of utilizing cymbals is creating a very melodic or musical approach to the drums. And to just sit here and bang them, you know, you can hear what they're all about, but to really hear them in a musical context, you have to hear them being played within a song.
Because each cymbal can sound totally different with a different size stick. For me, cymbals, that's the bulk of my playing. I begin with the cymbals. Because most of the playing is done on the cymbals. You know, the cymbals are the colors, the textures, and the energy, I get the energy from the cymbals. The Sabian cymbals definitely provide what I need for all the styles that I'm involved in. You know, and that's why I have so many different cymbals, and Sabian's always pushing forward to come up with new cymbals. They're always saying, oh, we've got this, check this out, check this out.
The hard part about picking out Sabian is narrowing it down. You know, I'll start with 8 and I'll narrow it down to 6 great sound and ride cymbals, and now I gotta pick what's like, oh no, I gotta pick one of the best. I think if I had to use a word, it's probably the most pure and the most focused sound, I think, of any other cymbal instruments that I've played. When I think jazz, I think HH. I think warmth. I think colors, I think a little darker. When I think rock, I think AAs and AAXs because of the sheer volume, the intensity, the brightness of the cymbals, which to me is unmatched. When I think studio, I think of their studio line. When Sabian innovates, it forces me to innovate in my playing. They come up with new products, new musical instruments, and it's like a little kick in the pants for me to say, wait, how can I add this in a mature musical fashion to different musical situations? It's very exciting for me.
I needed out of cymbals for me was real individuality. So in my quest and search for the sound that could bring what I felt out, I started experimenting with all the different models and lines that Sabian had to offer. Nothing greater to see than all these tremendously great, high-level standard artistic expressive drummers who choose all these different sounds of the wide variety of models that Sabian has and seek out the high quality and standards of their playing, and the marriage is matched with the high quality and standard of Sabian's manufacturing process. That is tremendous.
Well, I've switched to Sabian, and I think we've come up with something that exceeds my expectations, and I think it exceeds the company's expectations as well. The sort of Ur idea was to reach into the ancient past for the sound of the future. It's the ideal cymbal for me. It's warm, it's dark, but it has a brilliance to it when it opens up. It opens up very fast and it gets out of the way. My switch to Sabian has been something that's very exciting for me. I was looking for something new and something fresh. I was looking for a company that wanted to, that showed an openness to my ideas. So we've really got a wide spectrum in this line, with all kinds of crashes and splashes, all kinds of chinas, the china crash combinations, the bell-type cymbals or chime cymbals. It's just wonderful to have people who are enthusiastic, who want to move forward, who want to experiment, who aren't afraid to experiment. I just feel very lucky that I was able to participate in the series of alchemical evolutions that have, happened over the centuries, and to be able to contribute this.
To listen to the character of cymbals on records and how it can send chills up and down your spine when I listen to some of the great drummers. And to listen to that cymbal dancing, just shimmering, it's like, it's infectious. You know, I have this love affair with all of my cymbals. In particular, this cymbal here, which is a 20-inch mini bell. You know, it's like my American Express card of cymbals. I can't leave home without it.
And I've had guys come to me who are not jazz guys who say, you know, don't turn your back because I'm going to steal that cymbal, you know. To take a glob of metal into something like this that you would fight for, you know. You know, glob of metal you can hit somebody upside the head with, this here where you guard with your life.
I see the cymbals to the drum set as a piano sees the sustain pedal to the piano. So they sustain, they are the bridge to the rest of the set. And I hear them as an orchestra. They're not just one sound, they're many micro sounds within them. And I decided I wanted to make a set of cymbals, a line of cymbals that appeal to the mainstream drummers, but still had an extra personal touch to it. You have a nice stick sound. But you also have a nice controllable overtone buildup, which doesn't obscure the stick, no matter how hard you play it. I'm proud to be associated with a company that's not afraid to take a risk and be innovative and wants to be a pioneer in the cymbal making business.
I'm really trying to find cymbals that I can use in a lot of different situations and not have to like change my setup all the time, because I'm really comfortable with what I'm using now, and I'm finding that it really works, and whether it's funk, whether it's straight ahead jazz, or whether it's like a salsa band. Again, a lot of timbale players like the sabor cymbal because it's got that big bell, so you can really ride on the bell, and it still has all like the nice qualities of a ride cymbal, and you can still crash it.
A lot of people maybe think the cymbals are not really important, but you can't have drums without having cymbals. I come from a folkloric background of playing, and so for me it becomes really important in the sense that having a cymbal that has a nice bell sound as well as a crash, it makes it a lot easier because it means less bells they have to have around.
So cymbals can also be played with your fingers, but if you want this sound, you need to get yourself a Sabian cymbal.
I feel that the El Sabor is a perfect name for the cymbal because of the fact that with the variety of sounds it offers you, it's giving you a variety of flavors when you play it.
So I'm covering three different sounds, the bell, the ride, and the roll. And these are things that timbale players would need, or percussionists, to get to quickly and not have to be looking for a different cymbal with which to do that.
We're always looking for the one cymbal that, hey, I can crash on it, I can ride on it, and it's got a nice bell for that really percussive figures that we need to play in Afro-Cuban music.
I happen to be of Puerto Rican descent. And people in the Cuban community and other people in Latin America, we really appreciate the fact that Sabian took the time to develop this line of cymbals, because it's a show of respect not only to the music but also to the culture.
I feel very strong that Sabian cymbals give me the variety that I need for the musical situations that I'm involved with, no matter if it's an acoustic situation, a loud live situation like rock and roll, or more delicate studio sounds. I pretty much cover everything with the same setup that I'm using. Setup, I always choose cymbals which correspond well with each other but still have a very distinctive sound. Like a build-up, initial build-up in cymbal volume, I still look for a quality that punctuates out every sound, so I can still, even if it gets really busy, like I can still hear every note distinctly, like I'm trying not to lose the melodic quality of my setup, even if I get really busy. Have to say, the people who have been doing cymbals back in ancient times, they were very closely related to what a magician would be. They were trying to make gold out of ordinary metals, so they came up with Sabian cymbals, and that's not too bad, I think.
The band that I'm working in now is just a two-piece group. Keyboards and drums, and the one keyboard is playing all the instruments of the orchestra and band, and in real time without sequences, he's playing bass, chords, and soloing, and sound effects, and so I thought the least I could do is try to keep pace with him, and the way to do that is to start expanding the sounds in the drum set, and just taking a bunch of Sabian cymbals and putting them in all the spaces that are available. Stacking two cymbals together. So I'll take an 8-inch cymbal, maybe a B8 Pro, and put a 10-inch splash on top of it, or a 10-inch Chinese cymbal, and I can't believe the sounds and textures that I'm coming up with. I would have 10 of these things in my kit if I had the room to put them in there. They're all so special sounding, all very different qualities. Dark, not so dark, The thinner ones are my favorite. The thinner the Chinese cymbal, the trashier it sounds. One of the nicest aspects of being affiliated with Sabian is that from the day I started playing Sabian cymbals, I felt that there was a complete open line of communication with everybody at the company. Any questions that I had about anything was answered immediately. Any ideas I had in terms of working on a sound, open ears.
I gotta say, when I hit the Sabian cymbals, it gave me what I called, it had character. So, more so than all the other cymbals. And it was easier for me to find a cymbal that matched other cymbals. My ride matched my crash matched my splash. It all matched the China, and it all felt good. I'm playing with a group now called Tower of Power, a funk, energetic, a horn band. So I have to find something, and a lot of notes are being played. I have to find something that's explosive, quick, something that's light and sensitive. And something that has cojones also. You know. There's 10 players in the band, so my voice has to be heard also. So, but also I have to get out of the way. So that's what I look for. I look for warmth, sensitivity, and like I said, cojones. Just to call this a drum kit, it's not fair, because the cymbals are a major part. Might as well call it a cymbal kit. I have more cymbals than I do drums here, so it's a cymbal kit. The cymbals, though, like I say, each of them have a purpose. So, yes, you can drive a band with a ride cymbal, a hi-hat, and a crash. But, and I still drive the band just with those cymbals. All the rest, like, you know, the icing on the cake, the colors. I don't know, they can be sweet and sensitive, and they can make you cry. And then you can beat the hell out of them also, and they can just, you know, it can capture your attention. Sabian gives me all that.
How is the cymbals and the Chili Peppers? I beat the hell out of them, and I hit them as fast and as loud and as hard as I possibly can. And they have to be able to cut, and I find that with the cymbals that I use, and it seems to work for the Chili Peppers. They really are beautiful instruments, there's no doubt about it, and they're eye-catching, and when the cymbals are up and the lights are on and they're clean, and I play better. It's ridiculous, but I play better. I actually feel like I'm playing better. This is my new crash cymbals that Sabian's making for me. Called the Explosion Crash. I went up to the factory and had a certain sound in mind that I wanted to have in a cymbal. Hear the difference.
Her virtuosity and popularity have won her celebrity status and requests for product endorsements.
Can we have a little bit of a...
Sabian Cymbals not only featured her in its annual catalog, it's manufacturing a cymbal she's designed.
The cymbal crash can make or break the climax of a piece. If you have good instruments, it sounds fabulous. If you have bad instruments, it sounds disappointing. And Sabian Cymbals always produce a fabulous climax. Of course, I don't want to make it sound like the only thing a cymbal player lives for are the loud crashes, because there's something really sensual about soft cymbal playing. The quality that you get when you play just a pianissimo note. And the resonance of the cymbals.
Since the early 80s, with the advent of the front ensemble or the pit area, once people started grounding instruments and moving actually off the field, the application for cymbals is pretty much open-ended now in the front ensemble, as well as the development of the actual marching techniques of marching cymbal sections. Now they're not just limited to accents or crashes, but there's all kinds of different techniques that are actually put into the orchestration of the battery parts. There's a visual aspect to marching cymbal sections, and definitely the look of a section that actually hits a fortissimo crash and has some kind of flourish or some kind of visual that goes along with it is really, really unique to see. The great thing about Sabian is that they've always been very supportive of educational programs to help students in their pursuits as a percussionist, rather than just trying to sell a product, which is kind of unique in the industry.
Jazz cymbal is the same thing that's important in cymbals for other types of music. Between this low thing and this high thing, which are almost really the same note but in different octaves and whatever, that there's going to be like a gradual progression of pitches between these two that is musical also. So I'll just go across this cymbal that I've never played, but because it's a Sabian, I know that it's very much in tune with itself. So here we go. That worked out. One of the best things about choosing cymbals is similar to something that the great Billy Higgins told me. It's so simple, but it's so hip. He says, as long as they sound like a family, they sound like they belong with each other.
When
I'm not able to use my own first choice, which is the, you know, the HH cymbals, that every other line of the cymbals that I've played, I've been very, very satisfied with. Excellent cymbals on all the lines. I like kind of the traditional ping ride cymbal sound. But I also like the spread of a jazz type of a sound in the cymbal, like Tony Williams made popular, you know, kind of that classic, you know, sort of cymbal sound. And I find that especially in the HH ride cymbals, the jazz ride, which I think is an excellent cymbal.
Wonderful experience for me. Sabian allowed me to actually go right in with the engineers and the workers hands-on and try ideas. I mean, being an artist, it's wonderful to be able to go into a company and say, let me try hammering, half hammering, lathing, no lathing. Let me shave the edges with sandpaper instead of the machine. I mean, I wanted to try so many different types of things because personally, I didn't want to have a fully processed cymbal. I was trying to get something a bit more organic, a bit more primitive sounding, more metallic, more, I don't know how to put it, caveman, Flintstone, if you will, you know? Just... Soloing and the drumming is the kind of the same thing. You're hoping you're getting that real positive, blazing information. And once in a blue moon, the music plays you. You know, the drums play you, the spirit plays you and takes over. Playing cymbals, playing drums, or playing music is the one time where you can totally be yourself, you know. You can step on the cracks or disobey the lines or, you know, color whatever crayon you like to use for that particular moment. I think it's the one time spiritually and where you can be really free. In looking for my setup at Sabian, I didn't want to limit myself to anything. Sabian has a really wide selection of cymbals, and I wanted to just find something for me that works all across the palette.
It's really special to me just handling a cymbal and then placing it, particularly when it's new, on a cymbal stand in anticipation of what's to come, you know, as I'm about to play music. Like the full spectrum of sound, I look for all the different frequencies, you know, the darker tones that you get from the hand-hammered cymbals, the more articulate and clearer tones of the double A's, and the intensity of the double AX's. I enjoy kind of mixing some of all those in the range, and that really gives me a nice colourful palette to work from. And just seeing this dead, flat,
dark black piece of metal coming out of, after being pressed and heated, ready for the shaping and the lathing. It was a real shock, and I thought, is that what we're playing? It's amazing how they come up like this eventually. It's a wonderful process, and it involves the work of some truly wonderful craftspeople. I think cymbal making is a true art form. Quite frankly, I've never been involved with a company that's so switched on and really understands the business of drumming.